Greetings. Before we get started, the Whole Uglee Truth crew wants to thank you very much for helping us to keep our show going. Despite their awesomeness, Jamie and Paula are not radio DJs, professional comedians, or celebrities. So it's only by your loyalty and sharing the show that the Uglee Truth continues to grow. So thanks, honorary Uggs, or Hugs as we like to call you. We really appreciate the support. And now, on with the show. You love them because they remind you of your sisters and BFFs. It's the Uggs. Jamie?
I have my limits, and I would not have sex with Donald Trump for money.
And Paula?
And I love all the seamen.
Uncensored as always, it's time for the Uglee Truth.
Welcome to the Uglee Truth.
It is episode 137, I believe. Hello there. Thanks for listening in your cars and your homes, downloading in your little Do people do iPods anymore? Or is it all iPhones and smartphones?
I guess not. Like Victor said, he bought me...
Oh, did he buy you some contraption?
No, it's an SD card. But he says it should be able to hold all my music. And I'm just like, okay. I'm like, so how does this translate to my phone? He's like, well, you put it in your phone. I'm like, how do I get it on there? I know. That's my whole thing.
Is there an opening somewhere?
Well, and that's the other thing is I'm like, I use iTunes for everything, like my music wise.
Yeah.
But my phone is a Samsung. I'm like, am I allowed?
You know what? That's the thing. I have been an Apple device owner since I was forced to get a smartphone. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, I was really fine with the Razr. Like, I know
mind the flip phones. Yeah.
I realize people make fun of it and it's archaic, but it did what it needed to do for me. You know what I mean? I had my little ringtone. I had my little text message tone and I could press 7 a million times to get the words that I needed to text, you know?
Yeah.
No auto fill, nothing. And I was cool with it. Plus, it was really pretty. It was like a rose pink color phone.
I had a pink phone too. I think I had a pink Razr actually, but mine was, I think, a flip phone. I'm not sure.
I had a flip. And they kind of look like the Star Trek type. Anyway, whatever. Regardless.
Cool. I know.
At some point, someone forced me to get an iPhone.
And you know what sucks about that is like going to smartphones. Mm. I don't even know how to do a ringtone. Like, I used to love having custom ringtones. I thought it was the coolest thing ever.
That was my favorite part.
I would even do the ringback tones, and then I would customize them for, like when you would
sisters?
Call.
Oh,
it'd
totally.
Be like, it'd be like, hello, your sister's calling, or your sister can't wait to answer your call, but blah, blah, blah. And so...
I love those.
I want to say that our plan says, like, we can do that, but we have to subscribe to the service.
Dumb.
And then you have to pay for the ringtone. And I'm like, why am I going to do that?
Why would you do that? That's so stupid.
They're like, it's only $2.99 a month. I'm like,
$3
only? Just to have access to something that I'd have to buy? I'm like, that's dumb. That's like paying to get into Target.
It's $40 a year.
Stupid.
That's ridiculous. What a
rip. It
was
dumb. I don't even know if that's, you know, legit anymore if people do that. But I mean, I'm just not satisfied with the ringtones that come standard on phones.
I'm not either. And you know, I had the Sex and the City ringtone for all of the Uggs. I had Kim Possible as my text message notification, which was my favorite. It was the best.
That is a good one. I remember that one.
Yes. And it stays with the old phone. I have to repurchase it if I want it on the new phone.
And sometimes it's not even compatible because I think it says, we don't recognize sweet child of mine. I'm like, well, then you should apologize.
You should say sorry to somebody.
Right?
But yes. Anyway, welcome to the Uglee Truth. It is... the week of something, I don't even know, November. All I know is that I'm sick of being cold, and I know that we bitch about the weather. I don't care. Get over it. I'm cold, and I'm grumpy. I'm mad that I'm cold because we are not equipped with clothing. And that's what pisses me off the most. It's like, I wish that I was, you know, I wish I was like Kimora Lee Simmons and had two closets for winter and summer clothes, but I don't. So I'm scraping around looking for some kind of rag to keep me warm so I can go outside and empty the garbage.
God, you should have seen what I wore to check the mail the other day. I didn't
even
ridiculous.
Care. It's ridiculous.
especially when it was raining, because it was it rained for like, it seemed like forever, but it literally rained pretty solid for 3 days straight.
It did.
And so
it
the did. Kids were just, you know, they get to the point where they've done everything, they've played every video game, and then they just start following you around.
Oh, God.
Because they just want to, well, I just want to see what you're doing. Can I help?
No,
can
you can't.
And I'm just like, get away from me.
Go destroy like, I know. Something. Go outside and look at worms or
I have pick I the suggested. Weeds. I'm like, go eat candy, do whatever
do
you want
to do. You want to
play
do.
Your video game for hours. You know, just leave me alone. You know?
Yeah.
But then I happened to read because Ryan, you know, he's going to be finishing up his flag football this weekend.
Yeah, today or Saturday's the last game.
So he was supposed to have practice, and the previous practice we went to, it was really cold.
Yes.
And it was dark. And so I was checking the weather because I'm just like, well, I should make sure he wears like long pants and, you know, instead of just like the shorts and t-shirt that he wore last time.
Right.
And I felt like a jerk. And so, because
look at that neglectful mother over there.
Well, that's what I would say if I saw a little boy out there. You'd be like, look, he doesn't even have not even a long sleeve shirt underneath.
Nothing.
What
a terrible mother.
He's pulling his socks up as high as they go, and they're ankle socks. That's so sad.
I feel sorry.
I know.
Would someone just go get him a sweatshirt? Does anybody have a sweatshirt? Is there a lost and found here where he can borrow something?
And then one of the moms, she's just like, I have some extra hot chocolate if, you know, your kids want some. And I'm just like, fuck you and your hot chocolate.
Oh, God.
I'm like, we're going to Starbucks anyway. We're going to drink it out of our red cups.
Look, I may be a bad mother, but I will treat my children to Starbucks at the conclusion of this.
He can only have soy hot chocolate. He's lactose intolerant.
Oh, God.
Only a good mother would know that.
That's funny.
Anyway, so I looked at my phone and it said like weather advisory.
Aww.
And I was just like, weather advisory? I'm like, for what? You know, because I'm like, nothing happens here.
No.
That's when it said like frost advisory and it was going to be like 33 degrees or 32 degrees one night.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, what the freak is this? I'm
what
like,
the freak?
It just rained and now it's going to be freezing. And I'm just like, I don't understand where I'm at right now. This is not... You texted me and you're like, why aren't you hiding a table? Because I'm like, oh, we're at Chuck E. Cheese. And you're like, there's a tornado warning. I'm like, a what?
Yeah, the other day I was watching, I don't even know. Oh, I was catching up on The Walking Dead. It's a show that you would never watch. So I was watching it and all of a sudden everything stopped and it said, you know, Sacramento County Tornado Watch. Now, listen, we've had the tornado watch, the tornado warnings. If anything, they're like the little giant dust devil type things. But apparently the weather service, not the local weather people, but the National Weather Service, kept seeing this cell and it was twisting a bunch. And so they said, that's it. Forget it. Tornado warning, not the watch.
Right.
So it was hovering over in Elk Grove.
I know. When I happened to go and look.
Yes.
When you told me.
Yes.
And so I opened my little weather app because, again, you know, nothing happens here. There's really no reason for a weather app unless, you know, you have like the need to know what the weather is. But and so we're at Chuck E. Cheese and you're just like, why aren't you hiding under slides? And I'm just like, what? Mm-hmm. And you're like, there's a tornado warning. And I'm like, so I look and I'm like, oh, I'm like, well, I told Victor, I'm like, there's a tornado warning. And I'm like, it's like right around us, you know? So I start looking out the window and then I'm thinking it's going to be like a scene at a Twister where I'm just going to see like this giant F5 come, you know, careening into the glass.
What will we do? Strap yourselves down with belts.
Yeah, really, we'll be like hiding in the balls and, you know.
Hiding in the balls, yes. Anyway, so the weather's changing and we're ill prepared as usual. Okay, so as I've been mentioning for the last couple of months, actually, off and on, it's been quite the summer. Lots of life changes. And I thought, you know.
I think it's safe to say it's been quite a year, but.
Well, yes, it has been quite a year,
actually. Maybe the first half of the year wasn't so bad. I mean.
I
don't really remember.
Nobody died or anything, but I mean.
Well, you know what? If you combined our lives.
Oh, God.
It's been quite a year.
Yes. The films they could make of our lives. So I have not been very vague in my need to get away.
Oh, okay. Quite vocal. Yeah.
I've been very clear that it's time to find a way to get away. I don't care if it's for the night or the weekend, but I really would like to go and just get away from it all for just like 15 minutes. Could we just for 15 minutes not have a crisis in our lives? Can we just be somewhere staring at nothing and just, you know, maybe get hammered once, have a good dinner and some sex and some ocean and just for like a day. Would that be all right?
So he's invited to this getaway. Okay.
Well, I've seriously threatened. I said, I'm packing my things and I'm leaving. You can try to find me if you'd like. I'm out of here. I need to get away.
Well, I was just thinking when you threw in, you know, some sex and stuff, I'm like, well, that could be problematic if it didn't include producer Deb.
Well, that's true. So
unless it was, you know, you a solo show. I don't know.
Hey, I'm fine with the solo show as well.
Bust one out and take a nap.
Whatever. Yeah. And then wake up and see a beautiful view. So.
And nothing's crunchy.
No. Oh, God, no. Isn't that nice? Not having to change the sheets.
You don't even have to get up or get a tissue or anything like that. But there, I will tell you, there's nothing more embarrassing than waking up to your significant other and knowing that your little bullet is in the sheet somewhere in there and you like fell asleep like you were basking with it or spooning it or something
that.
And you have to pretend.
Like, how did this get in here? This is so weird.
And I'm the worst because I always open the nightstand drawer, but I never shut it all the way because then I'm going to put it back in there. And so if I fall asleep and Victor comes in and sees the nightstand drawer, like, you know,
a jar,
he's just like, hey, what's going on? I'm like, get out.
Nothing's going on, actually.
Just go. I'll be out in a minute.
It's a solo party. Get out of here.
Right. It was 2 hours ago. I've taken a nap and I'm over it.
Yeah, it's come and gone, literally.
Right.
Yeah. No, I do know what you mean. And yes, I could absolutely take care of business and not need a party to go with that. But anyway, I don't know what happened. But the other day I was feeling particularly loving and thought, you know, wouldn't it be great to surprise producer Deb with a trip to Alaska? Because he's always wanted to go to Alaska to go fishing.
Alaska?
Yes. It's like the last frontier, the final frontier. And for fishing, it's amazing. And he's been talking about going to Alaska for about as long as I've known him.
My friend is an airman stationed in Alaska. Mm-hmm. He went ice fishing yesterday in negative 15 degrees.
Okay, well, that's not what I had envisioned.
Not that kind of Alaska.
But the thing is that if we're going to go to Alaska and I'm going to surprise him with this plan, I need to find a really good hotel, because I'm not going to go camping and I'm not going to get a cabin with no heat or things. It needs to be nice. So I go to TripAdvisor, our trusty TripAdvisor, you know, and I thought, well, let's start with Anchorage, because Anchorage is the main hub of Alaska, biggest city, whatever. And like the number one hotel is like a Hilton or like a Homewood Suites. It's like real basic. And
well,
I went,
yeah.
No Four Seasons, no Fairmont Inn. There's nothing super fancy there.
I mean, not even, it's like Holiday Inn Express.
Yes. So I went, okay, well, what I've learned in the Napa Valley region or the, you know, up in Mendocino, there may not be hotel chains there, but sometimes there's lodging that's very exclusive. And I'm not a big bed and breakfast person, but they're listed under B&B, but they're not really B&Bs. They're like these little boutique inns. Yeah. So in Alaska, I'm like, all right, well, I will go under B&B and inns. Maybe there's lodges, like these gorgeous, I'm thinking these beautiful log cabin lodges like at Yellowstone, you know, real beautiful, huge, gorgeous.
Yeah.
So I found the number two in Anchorage is Judy's Touch of Class. Judy's Touch of Class is someone's house on a street. Their minivan is in the driveway. And I went, all right, well, I guess I won't be going to Alaska.
Why not, like, you know, what's the other place? Is it Kodiak or is that a bear?
That's
or
a bear. And there may be a Kodiak. But here's the thing.
Isn't there Juno? Or, I mean,
I've lost interest. I am not going to dig through Alaska's towns to find a suitable place. The fact that the Hilton in Anchorage looks like the Circus and their most expensive room is like $1.98. I went, no. No offense to Anchorage. No offense to Alaskans, because Alaska's beautiful, but it ain't for me.
Well, I mean,
I'm not digging around looking for a place that's acceptable. If I have to do that, I'm not going. There's a lot of green carpet in these places.
That's disturbing.
I'm not doing it.
So three things. One.
So Daryl can go by himself.
Most people who visit Alaska go via cruise.
I know. I did hear
And
that.
I know how you feel about cruises, but
I'm not a fan.
Alaskan cruises are actually, they're like I don't know, the Hiltons of cruises, probably. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You know, not your Ensenada, like not the little dumpy one that Victor and I are going to go on next year.
Right.
Two, Alaska procured and delivered Sarah Palin. So I'm not sure why you expected much more.
Well, because I thought it's Alaska and people go there for hunting and fishing. People have to have money to do those things because these are privately led tour type things. You don't just show up and trek into the woods. I mean, there are people that do this for a living. That means that people that go there generally have money to spend and they need a beautiful lodge, huge, you know, first class everything. Now,
I don't think that's necessarily the case. I think people who go there to, like, you know, hunt, it's like the same thing with, you know, I don't know, celebrities who hire hookers, you know, yeah. It's just like, if these rich people want to go out there and slum it, you know, they want to like really be in like the Alaskan bush people or something like that. And
yes, maybe.
And you know, they're not going to go back to the penthouse suite and drink champagne and eat strawberries or whatever.
Well, I was just thinking that we would do this and then I would send him off with his little tour guide and then I would enjoy the finer things of Anchorage or whatever. You know, I stopped investigating because I said, clearly, this is not a place that I will find to be a vacation friendly where I can just, you know, go to a spa and have champagne. And no, none of that in Alaska. Alaska's like the giant camping state.
Yeah. Well, that was my third point, was the other thing Alaska produces is The Deadliest Catch. Now, yes. I love that show, yeah. And I love all of the seamen and the captains and everything like that. But those are some pretty,
they're
like,
rugged.
Rustic, rugged dudes.
Right?
So I'm not seeing a lot of...
But you know what? You know what? This is one of those times where I'm really grateful we have the internet so that I don't have to show up like in a show, like in a movie, and go, is this all there is?
Don't you remember that back in the day, like you had to actually like call, you know, the 800 number or just the hotel directly and like, you know, find out if they had availability and you hear them flipping through the pages.
Yeah, they're going to sell it like crazy. I said, you know, I'd be like, do you have champagne? Do you want? Oh, absolutely. Get there. It's like, here, let me unscrew this for you.
Yeah, right. They've got cooks, you know.
Oh, we
chilled
have chefs
in the room. Yeah. No, I mean the wine or the champagne cooks.
Oh, God.
I know. You don't know what that is.
No,
it's
I do.
It's a cheap wine. Oh, okay.
I do. Come on. I know what to avoid. Anyway.
But anyways. Well, that was really nice of you. I mean, you should reconsider the cruise. They might, stop at a place where he can fish for a day or something.
I can't do it. I won't do it.
What is it about cruises? Is it the bacteria or the germs?
But, you know, I hate people. Why would I want to be on a thing where it's lines everywhere? General community, everything. I just, there's no, I can't do it. I know my limits, and a cruise is not something that I can do. I can deal with certain things, like I can endure Disneyland when I have to, but
yeah.
Other than that, you know, I'm really not a fan of, you know, being part of a crowd. Now, I have found these boat-like trips where there's 80 people, and it's, you know, you're going to Italy or something. I mean, they're really exclusive. Like, you fly there, and then you get on the boat, and then you kind of just journey up and down the island with, you know, 30 other couples. I might be able to deal with that.
I think that's worse.
Yeah, because really...
sounds like a swingers party or something disgusting. That's what I'm saying. You're in international waters. If you just disappear,
no one will know.
Say like, well, I don't know what happened to them.
What they
you
got
know,
off
gosh.
The port?
Yeah,
whatever.
No, the wife. No, I didn't think she was a total bitch, but you know,
she was a little cranky. But yeah, I'm not a big cruise person, and I know there are people who swear by them, and I think that's fabulous. It's just, I know what I know. I know what I'm good at, and cruises is definitely not for me. I can't do it. But I can't wait to hear what you have to say about it.
What, cruising?
Yeah.
Well, when we go, I'll let you know.
I
but I mean, I'm just trying to keep an open mind.
You should.
That's the only thing is I just don't want to, you know, shun something that I don't really know what it's about.
You know what? Every experience is a story to tell, but I just don't want to tell that story. I will let you do that.
I just don't want the story to be like, you know,
I got diarrhea.
An engine breaks down and then, like, you know, sewer starts spilling out.
Oh, my God.
Like, you know, everyone gets hypothermia or whatever.
Everybody gets that bacterial infection,
the flesh-eating poop disease or something. Like, I don't know.
All the toilets backed up, and we only went to Ensenada. Yeah.
And all the food got, you know, bad because there was no air conditioning.
Cross-contamination galore. That's the only thing I can think of is all the cross-contamination. It just basically
looks like, you know, Hurricane Katrina on a boat.
You know what? And the thing is that I've never been on a cruise ship, and I'm sure they're a lot bigger than, you know, it's kind of like when you see jets in the sky and when you're standing next to one going, God, I had no idea how big planes were until you're like standing next to one. I'm sure that ships are the same way, but I got to tell you, I would just dive into the water and swim back to shore.
Well, that's why we agreed about the Ensenada trip versus like the Bahamas trip. How far can it be, really? Like, if it gets that bad, I'll just swim. And, you know, we're going to Catalina Island, too. I mean, that's probably even closer, so.
I've heard Catalina's really super fun. Producer Deb went there, and he really enjoyed it, from what he can recall, because he doesn't remember anything. But from what he goes, I have a feeling that I really liked it when I went.
You know what? That's kind of actually, you know, since I do have the memory problems that I have, yeah. I'm just thinking, like, we probably shouldn't invest too much money and a lot of excursions, because the likelihood of me remembering them,
yeah,
you know, is probably slim.
Yeah, unless it's something you're super excited about, which you never know. I mean,
well, I told Victor and the kids the other day that I think our next little getaway, mm-hmm. instead of Reno or yes. Tahoe or the ocean, is we might go and check out Yosemite.
Yes, because the plague is always there, so that would be super fun.
Well, or you can, you know,
you can fall off the
get
side.
Get killed and raped by the maintenance man, you know.
Yeah, or you can fall off a cliff. There's
well,
so many
that's
fun
only if we go behind the ropes, and that's not going to happen. But and I'm not going to be a hero to save anyone either.
I would love, you know what? I would love Yosemite. Daryl and I have talked about going. There's a back entrance. And of course, he knows that. And so the back
How
entrance
does he know
apparently.
These things?
Huh?
How does he know these things?
Well, I don't know.
Well, you better hope it's a back entrance and not like, you know, a closed, you know,
no one road. Allowed. Yeah.
That's not even on a map anymore.
Yeah, it's like my butt. No entrance. Sorry.
Condemned.
Yeah, complete. Not condemned, but.
If you just can't handle only getting your ugly truth one time a week, make sure to hang out with the Uggs on their social networks. Visit uglytruth.com and click on the Facebook and Twitter buttons to friend and follow the show. If you do, there's a good chance you'll hear all about their ugly and awkward moments as they happen. Plus, you can share yours with us. Go to ugleetruth.com or search for us on Facebook and Twitter. And now, back to the truth.
Okay, so before we get into our outline, we've barely gotten into our outline. I wanted to tell you, and I didn't put it on there, but I read a little article today. We were talking about Blake and Gwen last week.
Yes.
Blake Shelton and Gwen Stefani are dating. And of course, there's like no sign of it at all this week. There's been no discussion except this. Gavin Rosdale, which is Gwen Stefani's soon-to-be ex-husband, he was cheating on her mm-hmm. with the nanny.
Yes.
You read about it?
I've read extensively about
it. Okay, good, because I wasn't sure, because we didn't talk about it last week. And now, obviously, what I found fascinating was she had more than one nanny, and the other nanny told on the other nanny. That's what was interesting to me.
So this is the fun... Well, it's not funny, but...
Here's the funny part about that.
The thing is like probably most people, and we're going to clue you in, I mean, although we're not techie people... This is one thing you should know.
Yes.
If you get like a tablet or, you know, an iPad or something like that, let your spouse queue it up and log in and do all the stuff and everything like that, because it will all be tied to either their cell phone or their Facebook accounts or their Twitter right. or all of that stuff. And so then if you have those applications on there, you can go in and look at their shit. And so yes. basically that's what happened yeah. is Gavin Rosdale got the tablet, and when it's initially asking you for all these emails and, you know, phone numbers and all the mm-hmm. stuff, he's just like, oh, you know, just linked it all up.
Going, agree.
Like everybody does, yes. right? And so there were two nannies. The other nanny that was not screwing the husband saw the tablet, saw the text messages and the pictures, because there was some nude photos.
Why do people do that in this day and age? Why?
The only thing I can think of is I've done the picture thing, but I never show up my face, ever.
I don't either, actually. I have sent not complete nudes, but I have sent, because, you know, I told producer Deb, I'm like, I know that this is something that all men love and they want, but I can tell you right now, there is just no telling who will see it.
Mm-hmm.
Just like the time when I had sent him a suggestive photo and he set it as his contact photo for me.
Well, and that time, every time you call or text him, that's the picture that comes up.
Right. And so one of our mutual friends asked for my contact information because they wanted to send me an invite for something. And he goes, yeah, sure, no problem. And he sends the contact. And all of a sudden I get a text message saying, oh, by the way, really hot picture of you.
Pretty sexy pic.
I'm like, what the hell are you talking about?
That was so funny.
I was so mad. I go, can you imagine if I had had nip in that photo?
Yeah, when I saw the picture, I was like, oh, yeah, that's not one I'd want sent.
Well, no.
I mean, it wasn't that it was bad. It
no,
was
but
just,
it was meant
you know,
for, clearly meant for one person.
Well, it was very suggestive, yes.
I was so mad at him.
So anyway, so this nanny, I guess, had sent her, you know, pictures to him naked.
Oh, God.
The weird part about the nanny is she, and they've showed some pictures.
Is she ugly?
Over the years, no. Oh. She copies Gwen Stefani. So if Gwen Stefani wore a green one suit jumper, oh, lo and behold, look, the nanny's wearing the one green suit jumper.
So he basically was banging a wannabe.
Of his wife.
Weird.
And she dyed her hair bleach blonde, like bright blonde.
Do you think that he made her do that? Or do you think she
did it? No, I think she did it on her own. And everyone kind of talked about it. They thought it was weird.
That is weird.
And so, yeah, so they had this 3-year-long affair.
Oh, my goodness. That means that she was pregnant when he started banging her.
And they had the baby. And he was still banging her. And so that's why she's been saying, she said it once, that her life basically blew up in her face in February.
Yes.
And so I think that's when she found out about the affair and she had been suspicious and thought things were kind of weird because she had been told before that the nanny and him would go and they'd hang out or they'd go for drives or things like that when the kids weren't even home.
How do you blow that off? I don't know what it's like to be super famous and in demand with my time being constantly in need, you know, like someone's constantly needing me, plus having family and a husband. I don't know what that feels like. I'm sure it's stressful.
I'm sure it is.
But if I knew that my husband was friending with one of the nannies, I would take care of that shit so fast. I would fire her.
So ultimately, she did get fired. And to boot, he broke up with her anyway. Well, after it all happened because he wanted to save his marriage.
And that did not work.
Of course it didn't work.
Well, I wouldn't either. That's egregious. You know what? We don't know their issues. But all I'm saying is stop hiring good looking nannies, everyone. Seriously.
If I have never said anything. Right.
Go
I'm
to,
like,
you know, stop hiring the hot Russians.
Get
you know?
Yourself an old grandma or,
find someone's nana. Seriously.
The only thing I can think of is maybe it's the young ones can keep up with the little kids because.
Or the younger ones, you pay them cheap. It's really weird. Anyway, I wanted to catch you up on Sister Wives really quick. I know that, you know, they're not as big as they, you know, polygamy is just so yesterday, apparently. But.
Yeah, I know. No, transgender is the new thing.
Right. As far as shows go. But no, Sister Wives is still on the air. I don't know how much longer it'll be on. It's become a sad show because no one's super happy and they're really forcing themselves to try to be they're forcing themselves to have like events and fun and positivity, and you can feel like it's, you can see that it's a forced, like TLC paid them to go to Alaska.
Oh,
for no reason. I mean, there was no reason for it.
Maybe you should find out where they stayed.
It was some giant house and it had the apartment carpeting. I'm telling you, it was very outdated.
It was, no good.
It was not
okay.
A nice place. So
I'm sure Robin, the one that already has 4 children and is pregnant, probably loved that trip.
Well, I don't know. It was,
she's so far up his ass.
Oh,
I don't
God.
Even, it's nauseating.
The new toy thing is still fully present. You know, he
must be.
He's completely ignoring the other 3 wives. They're annoying to him.
It's probably because he's been screwing them for 25 years.
Yeah, and he's only been screwing this one for 4, so it's
for
still
For 4,
new.
And she's 10 years younger.
Yeah.
And probably a good 100 pounds lighter. And, you know, and I know they said it on one of their shows before. They're like, well, Cody likes, you know, bigger women and blondes and everything. I'm like, oh, really? So that's why he married the skinny brunette? Because that's what he likes?
That's what he really likes. Right.
It's like, I'm pretty sure he's just like most men. He likes skinny pussy with big tits. Yeah. So.
And I didn't realize she's actually quite tall. She's like 5'10".
That's probably why she's skinny.
Well, yeah, if I was 5'10", I'd be really skinny too. Actually.
So would I.
We'd all be thin. Anyway.
I'd be a Victoria's Secret model on the runway. Yeah.
So the reason that I'm mentioning it is that next week is the season finale. Now, you and I talked briefly how Mary, the first wife, she was catfished.
Have they addressed that yet or no?
That is the whole thing next weekend. Next week is the catfishing story. She's going to completely come clean. So I'm not really sure. I mean, I don't think it's going to be as shocking because, you know, it's been raked over every reality television gossip site for months.
Yeah, but this was probably recorded before it even became an issue.
I think they've recorded new. My guess is the interviewing stuff is probably new because this person went public. But
right.
Robin is, she's due in like January or February.
Yeah, I think January. I think
so. This stuff that I'm watching now, she's totally showing. She's like 6 months pregnant. So
it was all within the last few months.
Yeah, they went in the summer. So most of this is not super, super old. So anyway, next week she's going to tell all the wives and the husband that she was essentially that she had some kind of online relationship.
Yeah.
And that it's all coming out in the wash. And now we get to see how they all respond to it. So that part I'm curious about.
The only part I want to see is the conversation between her and Cody.
Yeah.
And he asking her why. That's every couple, mm-hmm. no matter how many wives you have, that's every couple right. when there's cheating involved.
Right.
You want to know why.
Exactly. So it'll be interesting. I will let you know. If you don't watch it, I will let you know.
I might watch it. Although, gosh, I swear I have like Grey's Anatomy and Scandal up the Wazoo like on my DVR. You know, maybe I'll watch that tonight.
Maybe
but,
you will. Okay. So Paula, I just want you, I want to say two things about this. We won't go on too long about this. I am done watching Republican debates because there's just way too many. Like, how many more I know you told me that you're like liking some of them, and I understand because they've been thrown in our faces like every other week there's a debate. So at some point you're going to start, you know, recognizing these people like celebrities.
True. It's like Stockholm Syndrome.
Yeah.
Like the more you're forced to, like, you know,
stare at them and listen to them speak to you.
Slowly.
Yes.
Yes. I'm actually in love with Ted Cruz. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, my God. Oh, Paula, I'm going to have to drive over and I'll whack you in the head.
No, I can't get past the ears.
He's frightening to me. He's like a serial killer. No, I get it, but I'm over it. I'm over the whole the Republican debate thing. Like a couple of weeks ago, there was a writer, you know, I mean, they're like making demands before they're going to show up for these things.
I remember that. But that debate was ridiculous.
This isn't even is this politics? I don't even know. But who do you like? Is it Chris Christie?
Well, that's the sad part is he wasn't even on this one.
Oh, well, who?
But they had this guy. I hate him.
Marco Rubio?
No.
Ooh.
I want to say he's like the governor of like Ohio or something.
Is he?
He's an older gentleman. He's got like gray salt and pepper hair.
Is he always talking about war?
He's just always talking about something. And I'm just like, who is this nut job? Like he is just, I'm like, go back to Ohio. Because obviously it works there.
Yeah.
And that's not even a big state. But I'm just like, stay out of like the big pool. Yeah. Go back to the kiddie pool.
Yeah. Well, who is it that you found favor with this last debate? Because you said there was someone that you kind of liked.
Well, I kind of like him, but I don't think he'd be a good president. I know this is silly.
Who?
Rubio.
Oh, you know what? Rubio, I agree with you, actually.
You know why I like him? And this is so funny. He reminds me of someone we know.
Who?
Oscar.
Really? You know what? Yes.
If he had better hair.
Yeah, you know what?
It kind of reminds me of Oscar. And the other thing, too, is he's really, like, up to speed on technology mm-hmm. and, you know, efficiency and...
Right.
And I think it's because he's young. He could be a Gen X person, but he's more of, like, that...
I don't despise Rubio either, actually. Yeah. Of all of them, he's the easiest to deal with. I actually don't mind Chris Christie, except he has this thing about pot, and that bothers me. Like, he really hates marijuana being legal, and I don't know why he can't get over himself. So I'm like, I don't understand your trip, other than maybe he's a closet pothead or something. But I do like Marco
at
Rubio.
That weight may not. I don't know. Yeah,
he's
I don't
got
really
the munchies,
know what
man.
They hang up with. I mean, of all the drugs, really. But
of all the things.
Perhaps he would like to see something, you know, a little bit more racy.
Yeah, I don't know. Rubio
put on the ballot. He's like, pot. I'm not even going to deal with this. But you know, you put an Orco on the ballot, we'll talk.
Yeah.
So
true.
Yeah, I do like Chris Christie, although he's just too dramatic.
Well, that's his thing.
Everyone picks on Jeb Bush, and I don't know why, because I actually like Jeb Bush.
He's kind of like the redheaded stepchild Bush.
How is that even possible? Because George W. Bush was like dumber than a bag of rocks.
They all are. They just have money.
But he's well-spoken. That's the thing, is if you listen to him, he's well-spoken. He draws on his wisdom and, from his experience. And so I'm just like, the kid, he knows a few things.
Yeah, but you know what? Smart people don't get elected president.
Well, that's why I think Carly Fiorina is not going to get elected. That, and she just wears so much lip gloss. It's it's ridiculous. It's like,
I'm not, I don't know. It's hard for me to get invested in anybody right now. I just want to get past this part. Pick your nominees and then we can move forward. That's kind of where I'm at. I realize it's a big show and
yeah,
but it's become a circus to me. And it's not even Donald Trump. You know, it's just the whole thing.
No, he was actually pretty good, well-behaved at this last one.
Because he wants to win.
He must have taken his medicine
or
something.
Maybe he took a Vicodin before he got on stage.
Or Xanax or anything. Something. I don't know. Because he was pretty chill. And in fact, he stuck to the timer and all that stuff. And I'm just like, this is ridiculous.
Well, I want to know who's talking to him and making him kind of be normal.
I think I read that he fired his campaign manager like the day after, not the last debate, but maybe the one before that. Hasn't there been like four? I don't remember.
There's been three or four, but no. Well, the campaign manager is saying he quit. And of course, regardless. Trump is saying he got fired. So.
Donald Trump's probably like one of those people like, nobody leaves me.
Yeah, no one leaves unless I tell you to.
And so maybe he got a new campaign manager.
You ever wonder how he gets those hot chicks? It's because he's rich, right?
Oh, God, Jamie, he's ridiculously rich.
I mean, that's why he's got these hot women, right?
Of course he does.
Except for the very first one.
Marla Maples? She was beautiful.
No. Marla Maples was the mistress.
Oh, Ivana.
Ivana.
She was a model, I thought.
She's beautiful, but I'm saying I don't know how much money he had when they got married. I mean, I knew he was wealthy.
I think he was new money.
It's new money. Yeah, because his dad had the old money.
Yeah.
That must be it. It's the money. It's got to be.
Well, what would be any other reason?
Can you imagine being that beautiful model that he's married to and having that thing lay on you?
No.
Even once a week? Ugh.
He
demands like blowjobs and stuff? I'd be like, I would do a hand job, but I can't even imagine. I am not one of those people who, there is no amount of money that could be waved in my face that would make me want to, that would make me encourage me to have sex with something like that.
I could be purchased.
I could not be.
I definitely could
no,
be.
No, absolutely
Like,
not.
If there was, like, an agreement going into the relationship or whatever, like, well, you'll receive a salary of blah, blah, blah.
Just the idea of that thing being naked makes me just be disgusted.
But, you're assuming that he's only getting laid from her. I mean,
I'm not making any assumptions. I'm just saying if it was me...
Mm-hmm.
If he sat in front of me and said something and said, you'll be rich. All you have to do is, this or that. I'd be like, abso-fucking-lutely no. But my sister says she can be purchased.
I would do it. Well, I mean, ultimately, it's just a very, I guess it's more of a brash, like, arrangement.
Yeah.
And business. But, I mean, ultimately, marriage is kind of an arrangement and somewhat of a business deal.
It is a contractual deal. But, the smart thing these women do is they have children with him.
Well,
that is the thing.
If you have the boys, it's you can't beat that.
No, it's like having a czar. I mean,
it's basically look at Princess Kate or the Duchess of Kate or whatever her name is.
Oh, the one married to the prince, Princess Diana's son.
She got the boy on the first try.
Oh my God, pay dirt.
He Totally. Solid. She's golden.
Now she could have, and now she has her baby girl, and she doesn't need anything else. She's good. She's good.
She did a good job.
Regardless. No, I can't. I have my limits. And yeah, I would not have sex with Donald Trump for money.
I bet you he could find a nice hotel in Alaska.
You know what? No kidding. If he actually, if he said, you know what? Fine. I won't give you money, but I will build you a Four Seasons in Anchorage. I'd be like, done.
You would sell your soul to the devil.
For a 5-star suite in Anchorage, Alaska.
That'd God, awesome. Really? That's a lodge. That's terrible.
I want
that's
my awful. Own lodge.
Yeah, that's what I want in agreement. The word lodge.
Oh, God, no. No lodging in my agreement. Okay, so what's the deal with your apartment? What's going on?
We've had to tweak our recording a little bit this week because apparently upstairs, the people that had been there before have moved. And our apartment complex got purchased like a year ago.
Oh, right.
From like these young guys who made a bunch of money in Silicon Valley, you know, creating computers or something like that. So they thought it would be fun to come up here and, you know, purchase land because it's so cheap. And so they, you know, compared to,
they bought
an apartment complex in Elk Grove. God knows why.
Okay.
What they're having our maintenance person do now is whenever someone moves out, they're remodeling the unit.
Got it.
Which is fine. That's no big deal because, you know, we're fine with our maintenance guy and he's usually very considerate and all that stuff. Well, you know, the noise is kind of annoying, but it's, you know, it's not as bad up until this week. Okay. And so we contacted our maintenance guy because 7 a.m., I want to say it was like Tuesday, there was like this buzzsaw going off. And then you heard like that beep and it stopped. And then you hear the plunk. And I'm just like, what the hell? It was so bad. Victor and I had to put in earplugs because there would be no sleeping beyond that. And the kids are off track right now. So, and Victor had just finished his last night of work. So everyone was sleeping in, you know, it's just, we're not getting up at 7 a.m. because the tile guy upstairs.
Did you get a notification that they were going to be doing work?
No, we knew they were remodeling. So we texted our guy and he's just like, sorry, it's not me. He says the owner's hired a tile guy to come and do it. And so I'm just like, well, so he's been here. He was there from like 7 a.m. until like 6 p.m.
And so it's all day.
It's all day. And because, like I said, the kids are off track. They're out of school. It had been raining. You know, Victor's home from work. You know, we're not really in a rush to get out, but we're all sick of listening to the sound of, you know, all day long.
You know, that reminds me of when I was pregnant with Malia, we lived in a rental. It was just a house, but the guy, he needed to replace the rain gutters. There weren't any rain gutters in the front and it was causing some kind of wood rot. And so I was overdue with Malia and I went into labor and it's the pre-labor where you can't really go to the hospital. You just kind of have to wait and deal.
Yeah.
I ended up having her the next day, but that day I was sitting on the couch and of course I called mom and I said, I'm in labor, but it's not the kind where you have to go to the hospital yet. Mm-hmm. Daryl came home from work and we're all sitting around. Mom's like trying to force me to eat.
Oh, this was the house that was in the court, huh?
Yes. Mom's trying to make me eat sandwiches. And I said, no, because I don't want to poop it out later. Because I was really worried about that.
Well, once you start labor, your body kind of shuts down anyway.
Well, but she's like, you need your strength. You need to eat. And I'm like, I'm not eating it.
I'll push it out anyway. Trust me, I'll be more motivated knowing that I have an empty bowel than I...
That's exactly what I told her. So I'm sitting there. Now, laboring, whether it hurts or not, is a stressful time.
Well, you don't labor well.
I don't. So I have great pregnancies, but the labors are always very difficult. And so
they're painful.
I'm sitting on the couch and I'm just chilling and I have, you know, two or three people staring at me because
I know they're always waiting for you to do something.
I have children. I have our mother there. I have Daryl, who, you know, we all know how attentive he is when it comes to things like that.
God.
So he's staring at me constantly. And so it's uncomfortable. I feel like a cow at the fair. So the guys that he hired, they were trying to get it all done in one day because I think they had the landlord said, no, I want it done in one day. So they picked the day that I went into labor. There was like 10 guys there. They were on every side of the house. There was no room that wasn't affected by the noise of metal being drilled into the house.
God, you know I couldn't do that.
I started crying.
Since I insist on a silent birth, I can't have any noise.
It's true. And so
I was like that with both. I don't know why.
You were very like, shut up! Everyone shut up!
Everything was just so amplified.
Well, yeah, it's true. Maybe your senses were very, like, overwhelming you.
So the thought of that, I mean, I would have walked out.
Well, I was just laying there and I started to cry. And so mom's like, what's the matter? And so she turns to Daryl and she said, in the mother thing, because we all can do it because we're mothers.
Out of here. Yeah.
She turns to Daryl and she goes, you have 5 minutes to get these men off of this property. Do it. And God. He's like turned pale.
God, Daryl wasn't even 30 yet.
He got up and he got rid of him eventually. But I mean, it took a while. They're like, well, we got to make a call. I could hear them like trying to negotiate. He's like, my wife's in labor, you know, trying to.
Yeah, really?
But you know what? No one cares. That's the thing, is nobody cares. You think this guy doing his title gives two crafts? That you guys
he doesn't care.
Work nights? No, he doesn't care.
Yeah, we were pissed. But, you know, today you texted me or messaged me and said, well, I think we should be good to go at 7. And I'm like, okay. I'm like, that should be good. But he was still here.
He worked a 12-hour day?
I think that he probably is just trying to, you know, most contractors will say like, oh, it should take me 3 days. Mm. If they can get it done in a day and a half, that means that they have a whole another day and a half to do other jobs. True. So they're going to make more money.
True.
And so I think that's probably what he's trying to do. But or he's just the worst tile person in the world.
Well, he could be the worst tile person in the world.
Well, he probably was cheap. And yeah. So
I understand that it has to happen. And especially with apartments, it's the worst because there's nowhere to go. I mean, you're all living in a box. Like, everybody's pretty got much. Their little box, and they're all on top and behind you and next to you on both sides. There's really nowhere for you to go.
Well, and eventually you just run out of places to go. I'm like, we don't need groceries. Yeah. You know, no one's hungry.
We run out of errands.
Yeah. I'm like, we don't have to go to Walmart or whatever. You know, today we walked to the park, and, you know, that didn't end well, but I'll tell you why. And okay. So, but, I mean, it's just, you know. So there's nothing necessarily wrong with just being at home, but it's just terrible when you're like dealing with construction out, you know, above you all day long.
Well, you know, we have in our neighborhood, we don't pay for it, but most of the neighbors in our neighborhood pay a lawn service to come and service their lawns every weekend. Okay.
We had the landscapers this morning, too.
Yeah. The landscapers come Saturday morning and they're here before 9, but they're setting up. So by 9 o'clock on the dot, they are mowing lawns, they are weed eating, they're edging, they're leaf blowing, they're doing it all with every gas-powered contraption you can imagine. Now, I realize that most people are up and about, hopping about like a bunny at 9 o'clock in the morning on a Saturday. I am not one of those people.
No.
And it makes me really angry.
Even if I'm awake, I don't want to hear loud noises.
Well, that's the thing. It's like, what if I wanted to sit out on my deck in the sun and enjoy my coffee in the summer air? That along with the... It's like, really? I can't get over anything. It's like horrible. It is so noisy here. Not to mention at night, like tonight... There's two bars over in Old Town where we are. And where we live, it's amplified. I can hear the karaoke singing. I can hear the people singing Nickelback. I can hear them singing Def Leppard every weekend until 2 a.m. I can hear it.
Yeah. Well, that little like street, it's like a tube. And it just, you know, it blasts out it right pretty much on your front
when
porch.
When I heard for the third time, Pour Some Sugar on Me a couple weekends ago, I turned to Daryl and I said, you know, I'm almost inclined to go walk over there and find out who the hell is singing that goddamn song again.
The encore was fine, but the third time, come on now.
And the thing is the applause stopped around 10:30. So that means everybody got sick of it. It's 2 a.m. It's a very popular place. It's got great reviews. But if you're not in the mood to go out and party on a Saturday night.
If you, like, live there.
Because maybe you just didn't feel like it that weekend. You get to hear the pour some sugar on me. It's like, come on. Really? Who's allowing this? Where's your friend? Where's your handler?
Well, they're at that bar because they don't have any friends. Oh, everyone's friends, you know, after 2 drinks.
We're all friends. I love you. I love you guys. I'm going to sing Def Leppard for you again.
The holidays are almost here, which means it's time to start your shopping. The Uglee Mall at uglytruth.com is a great place to do just that, especially if you do what Jamie and Paula did and sign up for an Amazon Prime membership. I mean, who doesn't like free and unlimited two-day shipping, right? And right now, you can get a 30-day trial of Amazon Prime for free if you use the link in our Uglee Mall. You'll find Amazon and other online shopping links there just by visiting uglytruth.com. That's U-G-L-E-E truth.com. Thanks for your support. Let's get back to the show.
Well, we should talk about our ugly and awkward moments of the week.
Okay, so as I mentioned, you know, we've been kind of like cooped up in the apartment and there's a park not far from us. And so I said, you know, well, we'll take the dogs for a walk and, you know, Olivia can go to the little play structure and all that stuff. Yeah. So we walk over to the park. Victor and Ryan were going to catch up with us because I don't know what's happened. Victor discovered he has like old Nintendo games on his computer.
Oh.
And he got like USB controllers.
Okay.
So him and Ryan have been playing like Nintendo for like 3 days.
Oh.
And I'm so over it. And Victor gets mad because I'll be in the kitchen with Olivia and I'm like, this is what happens to boys when they get like, you know, in the video game zone. I'm
yeah.
Like, they can't hear anything. And he's like, why are you telling her things like that? And I'm like, because it's true.
It's absolutely true.
But anyway, so Olivia and I get to the park. There's mm-hmm. two little girls there that are playing. And so she played with them. They were Hispanic girls. And Olivia has a little Hispanic boy in her class. And he speaks Spanish as his first language. But
right.
he knows English. And so she asked me, you know, what I could.
Could you
what,
teach
if there was anything I could teach her sure. to tell him in Spanish. And I said, well, you could say, ¿Cómo te llamas?
Yes.
And she's like, what's that? And I'm like, well, what is your name? And so today she was playing with the little girls. The little girls were playing speaking Spanish.
Oh,
and so
cute.
They were playing tag. And so she starts chasing them, yelling as a battle cry, ¡Cómo te llamas!
Did they tell her their names?
I don't know.
Oh,
I just kind of ignored
so cute,
them.
Though. She's trying to play.
Anyway, so Victor and Ryan eventually showed up. They're playing football and everything's fine. And so these two, like, I wouldn't say teenagers necessarily. I would say they were probably maybe 12 or 13 year old boys.
Okay.
There was two of them and they were walking through and Victor was doing like petting the dog or something like that. And I guess one of them was just going off with the F-bombs.
Oh.
And so Victor said, hey, he's all, watch your mouth. And
oh,
so
dear.
The kids are like, oh, sorry, you know. And so they walked away. And as they were like exiting the park, they were probably a good 20 feet from the exit.
Yes.
But far from us, he starts saying the F word really loud.
Yeah, because now he's safe.
Yeah. And so.
What did you do?
It's like I'm watching another person. I don't mean to do these things.
What did you do?
So I screamed at the top of my lungs.
Mm-hmm.
I shouted. I'm like, he said, watch your mouth, you little shitbag. I'm like, you better fucking run.
Oh, dear.
And so I screamed it. And they turned around and looked at me. But the little girls and Olivia and
oh.
Ryan and Victor were all just standing there staring at me.
Crickets.
Like everyone at the park stopped. It was like frozen in time.
Oh, no.
And I'm
like, what?
I'm like, carry on. Go ahead. Do what you're doing. And so
the dirty work has been done. On with your lives, people.
I felt like an asshole though. And Victor's like, kind of defeating the purpose there, huh? And I'm like,
it doesn't matter. You know what? It had to be said.
It just irritates me. And I'm like, I was trying to do you a solid because I didn't like them disrespecting you.
Mm.
I'm like, it's rude. And I just, you know.
No,
I'm always gonna stick up for my peeps. And so I just was it was ridiculous. And, you know, the neighborhood was all quiet and everything like that. And
it's like all of a sudden you hear this.
Suddenly, like, all the cars. There was no cars.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
There was no dogs barking. There was nothing.
The crickets stopped chirping. No birds were squawking.
Olivia, of course, came up to me and she's like, yeah, Mom, when you did that, she's like, it was embarrassing. I'm like, well, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to embarrass you.
Get used to it.
I'm like, go play with your friends.
It's like, you've embarrassed me many times and you're only six.
I know, but I am going to be that embarrassing mom. You know what? You know how I know that?
Why?
Whenever we're at football, the kids, we were talking about it, and they're like, Mom, you cheer like this. Go, go, go. Come on, son, go. And
yeah.
they were, like, mimicking me. And then he's like, or when she's like, go, Keenan, go, yeah. And Keenan's another boy on the team. And I said, well, I cheer for all the boys on the team.
Yeah.
And then they're like, yeah, you even cheer louder than their own moms do.
Hey, you know what?
I was just like, why am I being attacked?
I don't know. You know why? Why am I always the asshole?
Always.
I mean, seriously, it's just who we are. Like when producer Deb and I, we go to every single football game that Malia cheers at. We know all the cheers. And right. Now, you know, I'm a cheerleader.
Right.
And they use cheers that I even used. Things haven't changed that much.
Like, yeah, they haven't created new cheers in forever.
So I know the moves.
So do you do your hands?
So perhaps I do my hands when I'm doing it.
Just little hands though, right?
No, I don't stand up and do the whole, I'm not one of those people, but I will sit there and do the little clap or the, you know, the yeah. moves or whatever. And you know, it's cute. Well, now Daryl knows the moves.
So you both are doing it.
He has a favorite cheer. And so now when they do that cheer, all 12 cheerleaders turn and look at producer Dub as he does it with them, and then they laugh.
Is it the one that's like,
hey,
super fast?
Go Broncos! What?
Is it the one where they like say something really fast and he like messes up the
favorite.
Words?
Oh,
okay,
no, that's my favorite. But he has his favorite, and then of course I have all of my favorites because I'm vicariously living through my child.
I know.
I don't care though. It's so fun.
It happens. Yeah.
So my point is, though, is that we really get into football. Now, we really love sports. And so when we're at the games, we know all the boys.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, we don't know them personally, but we know their numbers and stuff. And so if somebody, you know, if a flag isn't pulled and it should have been, you know, Daryl's standing up screaming.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, that's just who we are. We're passionate people. That's all.
That must be it. Yeah.
One time during a game, there was a flagrant, I mean, it was just awful tackle. He was like, he should have been kicked out of the game. And they didn't call it. And everybody was really mad because the kid got kind of hurt. And mm-hmm. so it was really quiet. I didn't do it on purpose, but it happened to be a lull. And I go, hey, and I started yelling at the ref.
Oh.
And he turned around. And he saw me. I yelled so loud. I'm like, that yellow thing on your side. Yeah, that's the flag. Pull it. Really loud. And everybody's all like snickering at me. Because you know? It was so super funny. Loud. And the ref turns. I'm like, oops.
But I'm the loud one. I just,
who cares?
It is what it is. You know, that's why I'm better at concerts, because it's so loud. No one can hear you.
It can drown you out.
So.
Okay. So mine is an Uglee this weekend. Well, what's funny is that it's awkward, but it wasn't my awkward, but I got Uglee. So I went to Ulta.
Okay.
Because I needed things. As usual. And I love Ulta. It's like one of my most favorite places to go because I love buying makeup. I love seeing all the new things. It's just one of those things that I just really, I truly enjoy going and wandering around in the aisles and looking at all the stuff. So I'm in line and the woman who's helping us is, I mean, I don't know. She's not like a teenager or anything. She's a young, she's probably in her early to mid 20s. Beautiful girl. And Daryl and I are having a little bit of a conversation. And she's like, how is everything? Da, da, da. Everything's great. And so he said something. I go, yeah, thanks. Oh, I said, can you hand me my wallet or something? And he goes, yeah, sure. And I go, thanks, honey. And she goes, oh, you're welcome. And I went, what? And she's like, oh, I'm really used to older people calling me honey because that's just kind of something I've always been accustomed to. And I said, older people?
Why are you digging? Like, why pick the scab?
She goes, you know, it's just something that the older generation tends to say to me. I said, oh, I see. Now, the problem is that she kept explaining. She kept trying to explain.
She didn't know how to dig herself out.
Right. And so she kept talking, and Daryl, he physically backed away.
God, you know what?
Because I said, you know, if you keep talking, I'm going to have to be offended. And she's like, yeah, you're right. But I just, you know, I thought you da da da. So I just said, okay. I said, you know, you're about a step away.
I'm all, let's move on.
I said, you really need to stop talking. And I said, look at me. Look at me. I said, how old do you think I am? And she's just like, well, I'm just, la, la, la. And I said, all right. I think we're done here.
God.
Give me my shit. It's
one uncomfortable conversation.
Because I was being confrontational about it. And I said, I'm getting offended. And Daryl goes, I'm going to wait over here. He backed off.
And she could have been a teenager still, is what you're saying.
No, she wasn't. She was in her 20s. But my concern was, and then I'm walking out, I go, do I look like an old hag? Do I look like an old lady? Am I elderly?
I don't ask people how old I am anymore.
I don't think so. I mean, I don't expect Daryl to be honest with me. But I mean, I expect someone to say something if I'm starting to look a little haggard. I don't have gray hair. Nothing. I mean, nothing that would indicate that I'm some old woman.
You know, I'm approaching that area and I'm like, I don't feel like I feel like they look good. And I feel like I should probably look better because I'm younger. And, you know, maybe I don't look that bad at all. But then I, you know, if I went to a bar, let's say, and there was a 21-year-old there, would they think I was like the freaking cougar or something?
You know what? Here's the thing. Okay, I think you won because mine was very quick and brief. It was awkward, but it wasn't awkward for me. I just got moderately ugly.
I embarrassed an entire park.
Yes. So we'll give it to you this week. But what I was going to say is what I appreciate about not being 20 anymore is I know myself really well. One of the things I know is that if I need something to be exactly the way I want it, I don't require or ask anyone to do it to my specifications. I do it myself.
Mm-hmm.
That's the difference. Although I may be a princess and a diva and all of those things, if I really want it done exactly the way I want, unless I'm in a restaurant or something, I do it myself. I'm not putting my standards on anyone else. The problem is that producer Dub likes to try to reach those standards so that he can do it for me.
He's a helper.
He's a pleaser.
Yeah.
And I get it. And I appreciate it most of the time. But what happens is, God, this is going to sound so terrible, but you know what? I don't care. I'm just going to tell you anyway. If he's been doing it for a really long time, he'll start to slack a little. Things will get they won't be up to par anymore.
So you become resentful of the initial.
He starts to phone it in. So this is going, okay, I know you're going to judge me. I don't care.
It's the flowers thing, isn't it?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
You say like, well, he hasn't bought me flowers in a while. And
No. I'm really irritated. That's not it. No. That's not it. This is something, we're going into the inner confines of my life. I'm going to tell you something that it's a little habit of mine that I've been doing for a really long time. I have this special drink that I like to drink before I go to bed. It's a ritual. It's just one of those OCD ritualistic things that I need to do most of the time. It is a small glass of crushed ice with Pellegrino with about 2 tablespoons of pomegranate juice.
Okay.
With a straw. It's very specific, but I love it. And I do it every night for the most part. He noticed it and said, I really want to do that for you because I don't get to give you coffee in the morning because I get up and leave so early. I would love to do this for you. And I said, all right, that's fine. So for a really long time, it was great and it was perfect. Well, he started to slack a little bit. Not enough ice, too much pomegranate juice. And here's the other thing. Pellegrino goes flat if it's left open.
Mm-hmm.
So he will open a fresh Pellegrino and pour it in. And then the next day we'll use that open Pellegrino to make another drink. But it's not as fizzy as it was the first time.
Is it in the fridge or no?
No. So actually leaving it out keeps it more carbonated.
Oh,
because it's like a natural mineral water.
Okay.
I know. This is so incredibly tedious. I can't even stand it. But I have to explain this to you.
I mean, when you have the perfect life, you have to find something this is not the something perfect to life. Complain about.
But no, that's not what this is. So the other night, he gave me one. And it had like 3 cubes of ice in it. Like 3 little baby crushed pieces of ice. It was like, it looked like an old drink that had been sitting out at a bar for a really long time. And I said, what is that? And the thing is I get mad at myself because I know that it's not fair and it's not nice.
Have you thrown a drink in his face yet to be like, try again?
No, but that's the thing is that I feel bad because he's really just doing this to be so loving and it's not nice to criticize, right?
Well, I wouldn't think so. Yeah, I mean, it's just like, you know, when your kids make you breakfast, you eat it.
Exactly. But the thing is that I told him the other day, I said, I want to tell you something. I don't want anything to change, but I need to tell you this. It's important to me that I tell you this. He goes, what? And he goes, this is about the drink, isn't it? And I said,
you already knew.
Yeah. And I said, here's the deal. I appreciate that you want to do it. I have really high expectations when it comes to dumb stuff like this. It's just a weird thing for me. The reason that I do it myself is because I have no one else to blame but myself if it's not perfect. Okay. It's one of those weird things. I'm a perfectionist. You're a perfectionist, yes. But we're different. You and I have different weird things about the perfectionism thing.
Right.
So I said, I'm really sick of you giving me open Pellegrino. And so he goes, it's no different. I said, stop what you're saying right now. I said, it doesn't matter. And this is when I threw it at him, and it felt really good to say it. I said, I am almost 50 years old. If I want to open a brand new Pellegrino every fucking night for the rest of my life on this planet, I'm going to do it. And he goes, all right, calm down. I'm like, don't tell me to calm down. This is why I do it myself. And he goes, first of all, you're nowhere near 50. I go, well, you know what I mean. It was really funny.
For heaven's sakes, that is so funny.
But it's true. If there's something that, you know, and that's the thing is I'm not laying my shit on you. You know, I'm doing it myself.
You're the one that wanted to be privy to, you know, the the routine. And so if you're going to do it, you can't half-ass it. It's got to be ever. The way I want it.
And I feel...
Maybe you need to have like a, you know, like a disclaimer, you know.
I just hate that I feel bad about it because it's like everything was fine when I was doing it myself.
You're mad that you're human.
I'm mad that I allowed someone. I'm just mad that I allowed someone to think that they can do what I do for myself. You know what I'm saying?
Well, it's not like you asked him to give birth to a child or something.
No, that's the thing. I didn't ask. He wanted to do it. And I'm like, I think you're a masochist is what I think. I mean, why would you want to do that to yourself?
He's like Tiny Tim. Please.
I know who I am. I know how crazy I can be when it comes to stuff like that. When it comes to my personal stuff.
Well, you know what they say. It's usually like the big time executives and things that are at the S&M clubs that are asking women to like beat them or like pinch their nipples. And
thank you.
You know.
Thank you.
Put a gag ball and stick a
right
banana up their butt or something. I don't know.
Although I will tell you this, totally take charge in the bedroom. I'm the passive one.
Shocker.
I know. It's true. I know.
Good for him. Good for you.
All right. Bravo.
Gosh, we might have to start your own segment of diva moments. Jamie the diva.
My expectations, you know, and I've had many people say you need to lower your personal expectations on myself.
I beg so you need to stop talking to me immediately.
So true. Anyway, in my little, that's just a little corner of my crazy mind.
Well, that's why you had such a bad week. My God.
The drinks weren't right.
Three ice in your Pellegrino. I just...
I know that sounds ridiculous, but it's not that. It's just the whole, I want it the way I want it.
At least your husband's not screwing the nanny.
Thank God. I'm never hiring an ugly nanny or being a good looking nanny or a good looking nurse's associate or whatever.
Anything.
No maids, that they will all be gross.
Or just find out, like, what origin is unattractive to Daryl. And then, like, you will only hire those people.
I mean, I want to say, like...
Don't say it. I'm just saying. Keep it in your mind.
Why can't I say it out loud? Because I'll offend someone.
Just keep that thought. Put it in your back pocket.
Edit It'll be yourself. Your ace. Just as our mother says, edit. Edit yourself. Fine.
Okay. All right. Well, I think that's a wrap for this week. Mm-hmm. We are getting close to Thanksgiving, friends. So start thinking about a space in your freezer so that way you can put the turkey in there or the bird in there, as our mother likes to say.
The bird.
I think I will probably have to, since I, you know, basically have midget, I shouldn't say that. I have little appliances. I will have to purchase the turkey like 2 days before. So
honestly, I can't even find turkeys yet.
Leave it in my sink. Well, they had them at Winco, but I'm not going to buy it there.
No.
I don't even know if it's turkey.
I don't know.
It's hard to say what it was. But anyways. So,
turkey-like product.
Yeah, really.
Turkey-flavored product.
With rib meat, whatever that means.
Ew. But,
so yes, we'll start thinking about your fun recipes and such and traditions and, you know, just be prepared. Be a planner like me. Mm-hmm. Other than that, have a great week. Stay warm. Get your sweaters at the store.
Okay. And get have your sweaters at the sweater store, everybody. Or Amazon,
Amazon. There you go.
You know what? Ugly Cuts is going to be really funny this week.
Oh, it's ridiculous. So I feel like Brick from Where'd You Get Your Pants? The Toilet Store.
The Toilet Store. Even Brick had something to say.
I know. Even the guy that can't talk had something to say. All right. Have a good week. We'll talk to you later.
Bye. Bye.
That's it for this week. We truly appreciate you listening and sharing the ugly truth with your friends and family. Until next time, get all the truth you need at uglytruth.com and stay ugly, my friends.